Morning students, hope so you will be fine and safe. Now today our topic is cross or vector product. Cross is called a vector product, like we called dot a scalar product. First of all, let's familiar with some formulas of cross, some applications of cross. Cross between two vectors, first vector cross second vector is equal to magnitude of first vector, magnitude of second vector and sine angle between both vectors. Second point, here normally we print as n cap. N cap means that is a unit vector normal to the plane. Now second one, if vectors are same, then what will be their cross product? That is cross. Now check out, angle between same vectors is 0. That means magnitude of A, magnitude of A sine 0. Sine 0 becomes 0. That means cross of two vectors, same vectors, is always 0. Dot product was commutative, but your cross is not commutative. That means if you want to interchange your vectors in cross products, then negative sign will be there. Now some applications, your third one, if two vectors are parallel, if two vectors are parallel, then their cross will be always 0. Or you can say AB vector cross CD vector is equal to 0 vector. I am saying 0 vector. Here you can see written is 0. It is wrong. It should be 0 vector. Reason being, cross is a vector product. Now cross is equal to 0 vector implies that both vectors are parallel. Or you can say if vectors are parallel, then their cross will be 0. Now if we have two vectors, supposed to be it is A vector plus B vector, supposed to be it is A vector minus B vector, we need a single vector which is perpendicular on both. That single vector will be cross of both. You can say C vector, a single vector which is perpendicular on both vectors, that is cross of both. Cross or vector product is used when you have to find area in vectors. Like in dot product, when we need angle, then we will use dot. If you need area, area of whom? First one, area of triangle ABC, area of triangle will be equal to half magnitude of AB vector cross AC vector. These are direct formulas. Now B, area of parallelogram if sides are given to you, adjacent sides are given to you, then area will be magnitude of cross of both. But if diagonals are given to you, then half will be there, magnitude of cross of both vectors. C, that is area of rectangle. As you know, area of rectangle is length into breadth. Length into breadth. Here you can see length is AB. That means magnitude of AB represent me length of the rectangle. Magnitude, first of all get AB vector, then get its magnitude. Length, breadth, that is AD vector, and its magnitude. Length into breadth. Here are formulas for your cross or vector product. Cross or vector will be used when in vectors question is asking about area. Now, cross between two vectors, first vector magnitude, second vector magnitude, sine, angle between both vectors. Now, cross of same vectors is always zero vector. It is not commutative. If you want to replace vectors with one another, then negative sign will be there. Now, two vectors are parallel, that means their cross will be always zero. If you need a single vector which is perpendicular on both vectors, then it will be cross of both vectors. Now, area of triangle, it will be always half magnitude of AB vector cross AC vector. Area of parallelogram, if adjacent sides are given, then cross of both sides and its magnitude. After that, if diagonals are present, then half will be there. Cross of both diagonals, get their magnitude multiplied by half. And after that, area of rectangle, that is length into breadth. First of all, get side, that is AB. After get that magnitude, get your breadth, that is AD. Get its magnitude, length into breadth, results to be, that is area of rectangle. That is the total concept used in cross or vector product. Thank you.